Hello everyone, this is Noah with Save Green here. And here we're going to show you basically the setup of the EcoSmart tankless water heater system. And what you see there is basically your water heater tank. It's a tankless basically, so there is no tank. It's your water heater, and then you have your disconnect box. Then you have your lines, your PVC lines. And something that you will notice that's a little different from something you might have seen in the past is that right there. And that right there is a $30 to $40 piece of equipment, and it can save you from having to buy one of these guys again, which can cost you, just on the equipment alone, around $300 to $400 for this guy. So spend $30 to $40 on this and don't have to spend $300 to $400 on the equipment alone, not counting the installation fees. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you what it does and what you need to do regularly. So it's basically a filter, a pre-filter, that's filtering the water before it comes into the tank. Now, the life of these things is the water. So if the water inside of it has a lot of sediment, calcium, and anything that can diminish the life of it, or the heating elements, if you will, that means you're replacing this sooner. So again, $30 to $40 will also extend the life of this guy. So it's basically a filter, where it filters the water before it comes into the water heater, and then of course it goes into your house. So this is the water going into your bathroom and kitchen and washer and dryer and whatnot. This is the water that's coming in from the city. You can see that it's shut off there and it's shut off here. I also shut the power off because you don't want this thing to have any power while you're working on it. But I'll show you what we're going to do here. I'm going to take this off. I'm going to use this little clamp here. You fix to put it in there, turn it, take it off and change the filter. And I'll show you that in just a few. Okay, so what you see here is we got the filter out, and or actually the filter compartment, and here's the filter. Now, I personally like to use the carbon filters because they last longer, meaning you don't have to replace them as often, and they do a better job at removing more stuff from inside the water. You can look on the inside there, it looks pretty clean. But I went ahead and bought these Whirlpool premium carbon filters. So you want to make sure that anywhere when you buy it, the word premium is in there. What does that mean to you? That means you can go 6 months. Now, you could take this with a grain of salt because manufacturers will always tell you you need to replace it this often. But you know what? It's all based on how much water you use, basically. So for a condo where two people are occupying and you don't have large families, you can probably go with these guys 1 year or even a little bit more than that. These come in a pack of two. And you can see there that it'll filter or reduces the chlorine and the sediment. That's what you want to make sure it does. Sediment is what kills those tankless water heaters. So get yourself a good carbon filter. Make sure it says carbon, or at the very least the word premium. Now what I'll do is I'll post a link at the bottom, and you'll be able to see a direct link down there at the bottom on the description where you can order these and just have them delivered to your door. Like that, you're ensured that you get the exact fit for your water filter. Now, this is very important if you have one of these tankless water heaters. If you don't have one, go ahead and spend the money. If you're a DIY person, do it yourself. If not, hire someone. But you want to go ahead and put one of these guys in, one of these setups, so you can clean the water before it goes inside that water heater. So I'm going to go ahead and put it back in and show you how it's done. So once I exchange the filter in there and make sure it's in there and it's nice and tight, you still want to keep your power off. As you notice there, my disconnect is off, and I'll show you why. We're going to go to the sink, and what we're going to do is we're going to, whatever air is left in there, we're going to run hot water for maybe about a minute or two, make sure everything is running before those heating elements kick on, just to make sure that there's no air inside the lines. So we're going to do that in just a minute here. Okay, so you can see the old filter here. Actually, it's been a year that it was replaced. So I'm going to run hot water here. And you can do this on all your sinks in the house. Make sure you don't get any air in any of the lines. So there you go. You can hear that. So we're basically vacating the air out of the lines and doing a complete filter change out properly. So it looks like we've got all of it out. One thing you also want to do also is ensure that this is nice and tight, which we did already. So we're going to keep this guy here, leave it hanging there for next time. And then of course, the last thing you do is you put your disconnect back on. Okay, so that'll now feed the power into your tankless, and you see that it did come on. Okay, I think we're all set. Yeah, there we go. So we're back to Fahrenheit. But you can see how easy these things are to set up. You can set the temperature you like, and believe it or not, 102 right here, these things are coming out super hot. And it depends on the application. They do have them in different sizes. So they got them for small condos, they got them for large homes. Depending on what size you get, you might have to change your wiring, which we did in this case as well. But in this situation, from where it's located to the breaker panel, you can see it's just a couple feet away. So we just took the wires up in the attic. There's your access panel, and it was an easy install. But before, we used to have a tank water heater in here. Got rid of the tank, put in the tankless, got rid of where the tank used to sit. We now have the air conditioner, which used to be up in the attic. It was also a service nightmare as well. It just shut off, so it made it a little bit quieter. But these EcoSmart water heaters are really good. They perform really well, and you get your water instantly, and you never run out of hot water. And for a small application, it's really a no-brainer, and then you can just adjust it here to the temperature you wish to adjust it. And if you need professional installation, you can hire someone, but you can get these. I'll post a link where you can get them as well. And of course, with your filter, that's a must. And go ahead and spend about $40 for one of these guys, and this will last a very, very long time. Thank you for watching. This is Noah with Save Green here.